Maintenu, Pyar Karta Haan. A lot of new content is being released with the Dynasties of India DLC, and it can be a bit overwhelming having pretty much 4 new civs to learn. Each new civ has their own unique bonuses, units, and tech trees to think about, and they can all play a bit differently. If you want to jump right into ranked play, but also want to have a basic idea of what you're doing with the new civs, then this video is for you. Normally you'd want to go through each civilization and think about how you can effectively use their bonuses, but I've already done that, so you can just watch and learn as I explain my thoughts on how the game can play out with each civ. First up is the Bengalis. The bonus that really sticks out is the extra 2 villagers that you get from each town center that you have on age up. Though this is a very strong bonus, it doesn't really start paying off until after early feudal age, since unlike receiving free resources, villagers take time to bring in resources. Since this is their only economy bonus, they have a completely generic economy until this point, which doesn't let them be particularly good at rushing. Getting to feudal age as fast as possible is encouraged, since the earlier you get these free villagers, the earlier you can get them to bring in resources. The 3 things that you can do with a very fast feudal age are scouts, no military full greed ecotechs and farms, and no military tower rush. Scouts are by far the most popular of these strategies, so in terms of taking advantage of your eco bonus, this should be the best opening. Economy isn't the only thing in this game, though. Considering a civ's tech tree to determine how they should follow up their opening is also important. Since none of the DLC civs get knights, the stable that you build to make your scouts will probably not be creating units in Castle Age, since you only have access to light cavalry and battle elephants, both of which have some major flaws that make them unpopular as the core of your army in early Castle Age. For light cav, their low stats make them lose to a lot of other units, and for battle elephants, they're really expensive and really slow, which leads you to being forced to take bad fights or not being able to chase the opponent's army. Bengalis does get bonus damage reduction and conversion resistance, which should help a lot if you want to push with battle elephants and siege, but you better be sure that your opponent won't just attack your base, otherwise you'll just die at home. I can see battle elephant and siege elephants being pretty strong if you get to Castle Age faster than your opponent while having a strong economy from your scouts opening. Well, back to reality. In games where you need a somewhat mobile or solid army, you'll either want crossbowmen or their unique unit, the Ratha. Bengalis don't have thumb ring, but they do have arbalester and bracer, so they don't mind playing crossbowmen and sticking to them in the Imperial Age. If you want to set up for crossbowmen play, then adding an archery range and producing archers during feudal age is a must. Scouts into archers can be pretty strong, especially against men-at-arms archers, but men-at-arms archers is more common as it allows you to attack quickly to keep your opponent open and then follow up with archers to actually kill stuff. As we talked about earlier, the Bengalis' economy benefits more from an earlier uptime to feudal age, so their scouts into archers should be something to consider. There's nothing stopping you from going up to feudal age at scouts timing and adding an archery range instead of a stable for defensive one range archers, so that could be decent with this civ as well. Since you can train elephant archers from the archery range, they're going to be a lot more viable than they used to be. If you don't have enough archer mass from feudal age to justify upgrading them to crossbowmen, adding in elephant archers from 2 ranges will probably be good. In this case, you'll hopefully have opened with scouts so that you can more easily get husbandry as well. As I mentioned, the Ratha is the other unit you can go for. A solid opening to get them is Drushfast Castle. You may be thinking that this contradicts the concept of getting to feudal age fast to get a better economy, but in this case it just delays the benefit but makes it stronger. Sure, you get the first 2 free villagers later, but you get another batch of villagers much earlier on reaching Castle Age. Straight FC into Ratha is going to be very strong on Arena, as the Ratha should be great at contesting relics. On open maps, I still think that Scouts is Bengali's best opening. Next up is the Dravidians. This is the most flexible of the new civs due to getting 200 free wood when reaching the next age. They have 50% off barracks techs, which pushes them towards men-at-arms archers play, but that's not their only opening. Going for drush into archers or straight 2-range archers will also be viable. Scouts play is not recommended with this civ, because you don't have bloodlines or husbandry, so after the opening, the stable becomes pretty useless. If you need an answer to enemy skirmishers, your own skirmishers fire 25% faster, so going for those is probably better than going for scouts. This bonus also applies to elephant archers, so with Thumb Ring, Dravidian elephant archers are like the machine gun crossbowmen for Ethiopians. Dravidians have fully upgraded arbalesters, so playing ranged units with them will be standard. I have a feeling that playing crossbowmen or elephant archers and longswordsmen might be decent in Castle Age with this civ. Elephant archers have 2 base pierce armor and a lot of tankiness, so they can efficiently support longswordsmen against enemy crossbowmen. The half-price barracks techs might just be enough to make longswordsmen decent, especially with the rework of attack move. With all that said, I'm going to have to conclude that men-at-arms archers is the best opening for Dravidians. Gurjaras is next. Their opening is completely unique due to their ability to garrison herdable animals into mills to make them generate a slow trickle of food. About 6 sheep give you the food income of about 1 villager, so it's not game-breaking, but it's still worth making your mill as soon as possible so you can get your animals producing milk instead of standing around. This opening is only possible due to their other eco bonus. Gurjaras start with 2 berry bushes under their town center. You can take these while you wait for enough villagers to efficiently take your boar, which feels really smooth. You have to take some wood from straggler trees to afford your lumber camp, but it's completely worth it. Once you run out of boar and deer meat, if you push deer, then you'll want to send 1 sheep at a time to your town center to collect from them. The 100 food that they provide now helps you a lot more than the infinite generation that they would provide over the course of the game. Adding farms is how you collect food once your natural sources are out, so the longer you can delay adding farms, the more wood you'll have for other things like a mining camp or an archery range. Leaving your sheep in your mill makes your economy worse than a generic civ for a very long time, because instead of having 800 food minus decay from the sheep that you could collect, you have to spend 240 wood on 4 farms to make up for it. Farms also can only be worked by 1 farmer, so the income is slow. I can see keeping all of your sheep in your mill being okay for some kind of all-in 2 or 3 range archer feudal play, but for standard play, taking at least 5 of them after your other animals will be necessary to have a proper feudal age and get to castle age on time. Since Gurjaras go for mill first, this does not allow them to go pre-mill drush. They can still go for a later drush, but at that point they should probably just do men-at-arms archers. They don't have the greatest crossbowmen, but they at least have crossbowmen, so it's not too bad to hit an early Castle Age crossbowman timing and then transition to something else. Gurjaras' main opening will probably be scouts. They start with a camel scout, which eats scout cavalry once reaching feudal age, and they can add more from their stable. The camel scout has 70 HP and receives less damage from spearmen, so it can be used to tank spearmen hits while the scout calves kill them. You need to go to gold to make camel scouts, which gives you the opportunity to add in bloodlines if you want to rely on your cavalry in feudal age to take fights against archers and spearmen. With the extra food from their garrisoned sheep, they can afford to spam more scouts than most civs, so it can be viable for Gurjaras to get upgrades for them early. The Gurjaras also get their unique Shrivamsha rider, which performs well against anything that has a projectile attack. This further encourages them to play scouts opening. Since they don't have a cavalry unit capable of dealing with pikemen, siege or their unique chakram throwers can be added when pikemen numbers get out of control. Pikemen will probably be difficult for Gurjaras to deal with. I can see Shrivamsha rider and chakram throwers synergizing very well, but adding a castle can be a huge expense, so it might be tough to get to it. Scouts should be Gurjaras' default opening. The last civ is the reworked Indian civ, the Hindustanis. They still have their staggered cheaper villagers bonus, which is one of the best eco bonuses in the game. If you produce 15 villagers for a 19 pop scouts opening, you already save 75 food in Dark Age. The food savings can also help a men-at-arms archer's rush, but like the Gurjaras, they lack some upgrades for their archer line in the late game, so you'll have to transition from archers eventually if you go for them early. A new bonus that was added to the Hindustanis is that their scout cavalry and camel line do +2 additional damage to buildings. This applies in feudal age, so their scouts share some of the functionality of men-at-arms, while still being mobile. This makes me think that maybe scouts into archers instead of men-at-arms archers will be better with them. Hindustani camels attack 25% faster, which especially helps at taking out buildings. It also gives them a much better fight against pikemen than other camels, though you still don't want to fight them very often. This civ really wants you to play scouts with them. The follow-up with archers can be fine, but it can delay you from getting to Castle Age, where you get even cheaper villagers. And that's it for all four civs. Just to recap my conclusions, the best openings are Scouts or Drush FC Ratha for Bengalis, Man-at-Arms Archers for Dravidians, Scouts with potential for feudal upgrades for Gurjaras, and Scouts into Castle Age or Archers for Hindustanis. Remember that just because you know the most optimal strategy doesn't mean it's always the one that you want to go for. You have to consider factors such as the opponent's civ and opening, as well as the map. Hopefully this has been informative and has given you some insights into the new civs. The concepts that I've gone over can be applied to other civs as well, so you should be able to more easily think about your opening based on your civ bonuses and tech tree. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.